Gentlemen, there is a difference between being a nice guy and a nice guy. There is also a difference between being a bad boy and a bad boy. The one that drives all the senoritas loco. Oh my God, Brenda, bad boy, 6 o'clock. Truth is, you should be a nice guy, right? You should do things for people, but you shouldn't be a pushover. You should also want to look like a bad boy, even though you've got a solid 5-year plan. Oh shucks, Alpha, I think I am. I think I'm a nice guy. Hush, don't worry about it. Alpha's got you hooked up. Today, I'm going over 6 style tricks to go from nice guy to bad boy. If you implement these 6 style tricks, it doesn't matter if you are the nicest guy. You're gonna look like a super freaking bad boy, and looking like a bad boy is half the battle, starting with number 1. Wear a turtleneck.
Huh? Turtleneck? Lame.
With a suit. The turtleneck with the suit. So this is something that I discovered the power of a few months ago. I went to my cousin Tommy's wedding. I was like, yo, I want to do something a little different. I don't necessarily want to wear a tie. So I was like, yo, let me wear a turtleneck with the suit. Let me tell you what happened. I'm not saying, I'm just saying that I got more looks from like every woman in that place whose dude was wearing just like a tie and like a white shirt with like it was mind blowing. My wife even noticed. She's like, everybody is checking you out. You look too sexy. Too sexy? Not even possible. Gentlemen, if you want to kill it in a level of killing it in terms of sexiness that you have never experienced, I didn't even know it was going to happen. I just did it and I was like, my God, man, this is some good stuff I got to share with the guys. Here I am walking around the wedding and I felt like a piece of meat. And I loved it. Number 2. Ditch the stripes. Gentlemen, nice guys are notorious for wearing bright, vibrant, playful colors with stripes. Nothing screams nice guy like a striped shirt. Instead, bad boys go black, solid. They don't wear stripes all that much. Stripes, nice guy. Solid, monochromatic, amazing. This polo is the most perfect polo in the history of polos. It came from today's video sponsor, Public Rec. What do you think? This polo, it's nuts, right? It's so incredible. It's the perfect length. It's got a little side detail that's incredible. I love the contrasting placket, the collar. It's not too like big and wide, so it doesn't get all floppy. If you have not checked out Public Rec, you are missing out because their clothing is so incredible in terms of a casual slash athleisure slash just awesome. I know it's not polo season yet, but the deal is this. If you want to make sure that you get an incredible polo, now is the time, guys. I will link to Public Rec, this polo, along with some of the other favorites of mine, including their Henleys. Their Henleys are ridiculous. Guys, they come in a ton of different fun colors, including like blue, maroon, black, this gray. It's just incredible. The fit is amazing, but the fabric, that's the thing with Public Rec that will blow you away. The quality of Public Rec clothing is insane. The all day, everyday pant, which I have worn for like years now, the first pair I ever got still is as black as it was the day I got it. It's not all stretched out. The fabric still looks amazing. The thing that I love about these is that number one, they're so crazy comfortable. The fabric's super stretchy. They're also nice and tapered down to the ankle without being like super tight like joggers. They come in sizes, like you pick your waist size and inseam. Sort of like regular pants, but they feel like sweatpants, but they're super sleek and sexy. Guys, there's a link down below to everything that I showed along with everything else that Public Rec sells. There's also a discount code. That discount code is for a limited time. So if you like anything, you gotta grab it because they will definitely sell out at the price they're offering. So hit that link and grab some bad boy casual clothes. Number 3, buttons. Hi, Brenda, I'm Brian, and I would love to go out with you. What do you think? Would you like to be interested in possibly going on a date and grabbing a burrito? Let's try that again. Sup, Brenda? Yeah, Alpha. I was thinking, you, me, burrito, now, let's do this, woman! See the difference? It's all about chest exposure, gentlemen. That is what bad boys do. They're not afraid to show a little man cleavage, a little skin. But if you are going to be showing the man cleavage, you gotta make sure that you're manscaped. I'm not saying that you gotta shave bald like I do. Do you look sexy? Yes. Do you look like a bad boy? Hell yes! A super macho, hairy, testosterone coursing bad boy. Speaking of exposure, the 4th thing that makes you look like a bad boy is exposing your forearm. Roll and pull, gentlemen. It's all about proper forearm exposure. Why? Because nice guys like to stay covered up, right? But when a woman or a man, whatever you're into, sees those blazing guns of forearms that you got rocking, they can't help but be like, oh my God, you are the sexiest thing since Alpha. Freak out and lose their minds, because there have been studies done that have proven the fact that the number one sexiest male body part that a dude has is his forearms when they're exposed. So make sure you do it and look like a bad boy number five. Ditch the blue jeans for gray or black stretch denim. Why? Because nice guys wear blue. There is a direct correlation between dudes who wear gray or black jeans and them being perceived as bad boys. The AlphaM Research Institute for How to Look Like a Bad Boy, even if you're a nice guy, has done the studies, and it indicates that you gotta wear gray or black jeans. Number six. Accessorize like a bad boy, because nice guys aren't wearing beaded bracelets, they're not wearing cool chains and dope ass shades. Gentlemen, here's the deal. Nice guys aren't rocking accessories. They're not doing bracelets, cool rings, or the proverbial dope ass shades. No, they're too busy being safe, being nice. They don't want to rock the boat. I know that you're a nice guy. We all should be nice guys, but we just shouldn't be nice guys. And even if you are, even if deep down you're that little tender soul that's just so nice to everybody, you can still look like a bad boy.